guys. Welcome to the workshop. We're in Boston right now. Let me get the screen share. Hold on 1 second.
It's gonna get out of control.
There we go. Just gonna click present. Hope it doesn't go to a black screen.
All right, guys, thank you.
There we go.
Getting some feedback from Michael. All right. All right, well, thanks, sir. Thanks for having us. Logged in. So, I'm Mitch Weiss. I'm a visual artist and imaging consultant with National Geographic. And I'm here today with Cavanagh. I'm a system administrator, performance computing system administrator with a background in research science. He's also modest, spent about a decade at Harvard studying human brain, so it's been fun with you. So we've attempted to pair art science to harness the power of politeia within the framework of National Institute of Health, which is the main biomedical public health research funding. So currently, the database at NIH only allows the query of granted proposals, and it's on a centralized system. So the idea would just use Politeia as the back end for this new concept of an NIH way of doing grants and logging each step of the process and leveraging the features of Politeia to provide visibility into the submission and the entire management process, censorship, and archiving as well.
This is their current proposal management system, and here we have a concept of what a page might look like with a rebrand and the integration of the CD. And this is a photograph that I made this year on 8x10 inch film. So some of the benefits of using Politeia versus the traditional system, well, one of the main things I should say is to prevent false attribution to the authors. So in the code, we added secondary level of censorship, which protects the original content and the respective authors.
And just to expand on that, the additional feature is to mark a proposal as a duplicate of another proposal.
And I think one unique feature here is that this first point, that all steps of the proposal are legible and searchable, or I should say, sort of anchored to the blockchain. So the submission, the review, the award, and the archive, all funded and not funded proposals, will be logged and available to the public.
And that potentially would be an improvement for innovation, just the idea that you can see information about proposals that were not funded. That information just be as important, for new ideas that are coming forward. And the last potential thing is similar to how the proof of stake and automated code implementation works for Politeia. Imagine that something similar could be done for a scientific environment. Scientific proposals are put forth or integrated. If Decred hypothetically is being used as the currency. This would link back into the mining, proof of stake, voting, and then the cash, the grant funding, the scientific rewarding could be automated. And another benefit would be the public having the ability to participate in this voting process on what science gets funded.
And I think here we'll dive a little bit into what changed in the code to allow this to happen.
Here we are. The way that this was achieved was I'm not sure how familiar everyone is with the code, but there's a function in the API for set unvetted status. to allow you to label a proposal as a censored. What it did was essentially duplicate the mechanisms for that function throughout the code base, and I said use, unfortunately, use the word duplicate. I copied, modified the set unvetted status function and created a second function, set unvetted duplicate, which allows the labeling of a proposal with a status. The status is still censored, but I did include a duplicate status in addition to the five status that was already there. There's now six. The other feature here is that the new status field in the record is a duplicate status field that actually points to the token of the original originally authored proposal. So in this way, imagining similar to some ticketing system, if you use any kind of software development where the tickets are marked or flagged, they're getting point to the other ticket, similar concept. So I'll try and list off the files that were changed. I'm not sure how much detail everyone wants to hear, and so I'm going to go a little bit superficially, assuming that hopefully that the judges or others have had a chance to review the code. Edited the additions were to the Politeia.d.go file, the API, v1.go, that needed enhancements there for the new functionality, the interface. In the backend, backend.go and backend.go, features for additional metadata modification, and the status, the additional inclusion of the new status field, and the ability to display the new field. I think I'm going to move on. I'm not sure how it's the complicated set of changes. I thought it was going to be simple first, and then I started to implement and
some late.
This is a screenshot just showing the running of the. I'm going to outline what we're going to do. First, I'm going to show you creating two proposals, and then in the second step, we'll actually run the new function, which will mark one as duplicate. So here we're just creating two proposals using the Politeia command line. I'll mouse over here a little bit. Some of the parameters and the new function. And here's the text file containing the text of the proposal. Here's the second, we're getting back the token, which we'll use later. Second proposal, this is the copycat, and we get the second token here. Moving on, so here's the second step where we're actually, an administrator will be running this command and vetting or recognizing that a proposal exists and it's a copy of another one. So we'll label it as a duplicate. So here, similar with modifications, I thought that I modified the client as well to incorporate the API and allow this, passing through the new function. Here is the set embedded duplicate function with a duplicate status. And the first token is the ticket that is going to be marked as the duplicate, censored. The second token is the token of the ticket that was the original ticket that was we're going to point it to. So we get the censored status as returned, the command is successful. And in the second command here, I just ran the get unvetted command to display this ticket. So this is the censored ticket. We're displaying it. And you see the status has been updated to censored timestamps. And here, the duplicate field has been added. And it's pointing to what was duplicated. That's the essential demonstration of the additional functionality that was incorporated to try and, again, to illustrate what would be potentially in the use case of NIH managing grant, scientific grant proposals, this is potentially something that would come up and be relevant.
I think before we jump into questions, comments, if there's time for that, I think just really like, the main reason for even implementing this bin is not just the sort of preventing plagiarism, which is useful for this, but also keeping a log of ideas entered the system to really force innovation, because right now it's really difficult to look at what was submitted, why it was submitted, what ideas were, and kind of go under it. So keeping everything on the blockchain, I think, can be really helpful.
And more openness, more exchange of information.
Yeah, I mean, that's what this is all about. That's also why we believe in DeepGrad. Thoughts on your
I think that is what we prepared for our presentation.
Okay. I think that sounds great. What do you guys think? Good? That is clapping for you guys.